3 games remain in the regular season for the South Dakota State football team. And for the Jackrabbits to have any shot at an FCS postseason bid, they have to win out. They play 2 at home to end the year, but the final road trip of the regular year is today in Terre Haute, Indiana, against a much-improved Indiana State football team that is thinking it could make the playoffs for the first time in 30 years. Jacks a third down and a long 4, just shy of their own 30. It's Zenner up the middle, weaves his way across the 35, out near the 39 of his own territory for an SDSU first down. Nice call by Eric Eidsness. 3rd and 4, Wesley Winicky. Schneider trips left, Cam Jones tight right, Zenner behind into the right of Sumner in the gun. Sumner takes the shotgun snap over the middle, has a first down into Indiana State territory. Pass complete to Jason Schneider, out to the Sycamore 48. No score, 6:45 to play in the first quarter. Trips right on 4th and 4. Sumner takes the snap, rolling right, pressured, throwback screen for Cam Jones, and he overthrew him. Jones had 3 linemen to block in front of him. If he's able to make that catch, Jones might have gone all the way, but Sumner overthrew him. Jackrabbits facing a 3rd down and 4 at their own 41. 2 receivers left and 2 to the right. 3 down linemen for the Sycamores. They only bring 3. Sumner will throw the out near side, and the pass is caught for first down yardage at the 46 of Indiana State territory by Brandon Andrews. Under 3 to play in the opening quarter, we're scoreless in Terre Haute, Indiana. Wrong way turned with Zenner, broken play. Sumner throws down the middle, and it is intercepted at the 43-yard line of South Dakota State territory. Mark Seawall, his first interception of the season. This will be the first time we see Ethan Sawyer today, the senior out of Brandon, averaging 39 per punt. High snap, it's through the hands of Sawyer. He'll pick it up at the 25, tried to pooch it. It is blocked high into the air and out the back of the end zone. Safety, Indiana State is on the board. Indiana State 2, SDSU nothing, and Carlson will kick from right to left into a breeze. It's a line drive, end over end job that's going to land at the 25 and go out of bounds near the 18-yard line. So the Sycamores leading 2-0 with 12:41 to go in the second quarter, a 1st and 10 at midfield. 2 wide left and 1 to the right. Play fake to Buck Logan. Throw the screen to A.J. Johnson left side, who shucked 1 defender, but well played by Melvin Tavares. 3rd and 1 yard at the 41. 1 back to either side of the quarterback. Parrish takes the helmet eye snap. Hands to Buck Logan. 1st down yardage to his own 37, near his own 36. Now Logan in motion out of the backfield. Empty set for Parrish. He'll look right, throw it behind the line. Now looking to throw it as O'Leary back to the quarterback Parrish. Along the far sideline. Line 20. He's inside the 10 and is run out of bounds by Forsyth and Mears at the SDSU 4. An extra lineman into block for Indiana State. Marcus Smith at 3:35 is in the backfield. Tight end to the right as well. They'll both lead for the running back Logan, who jumps the pile inside the 1, and he crosses the plane to the goal line into the end zone for an Indiana State touchdown. Sumner in the shotgun. And Zenner is to his right. Dropping to throw the quarterback. Screen to the near side. Zenner has it. Cuts past a man across the 30. And he has 1st down yardage on the catch out of the backfield near the 38-yard line. 1st and 10 Jacks at their own 38. 1 wide to either side. 9-0 Sycamores. 9-10 second quarter. Zenner stretch play right side. Gets around end 40, 45. Turns up the field and he crosses into Indiana State territory. He's hit down to the Sycamore 47-yard line. 3rd and 6. Only 2 down linemen for the Sycamores. They walk 2 more up to the line. 2 wide either side. Sumner in the shotgun. Pump fake. He evades a sack. Now he'll throw deep across his body left side for Winicky. And jumping to intercept it at the 10-yard line is Mark Seawall. 9-0 Indiana State. Jacks on the move with 6:10 left in the second quarter. Sycamores blitz. Sumner going deep down the right side and a tremendous leaping grab by Trevor Wesley inside the 30. He is hauled to the turf at the 26-yard line. Center out, Mengarelli in on 1st and 10 at the 26. Sumner the slant over the middle and Jake Winicky makes the catch, just keeps powering forward to the 14-yard line of Sycamore territory. First and 10, Indiana State 14. Sumner drops to throw out of the shotgun. Hits Mangarelli out of the backfield, up the middle inside the 10, between the hashes down to the 7-yard line. Two wide, both left. Now Lauscher out in motion out of the backfield, lines up wide right. Sumner to throw. Mangarelli out of the backfield, makes the catch at the 5, is able to break away from a tackle shy of the sticks and fight his way to the Sycamore 1. 6 yards and a first down. He was hit shy of the sticks.
Jack's coming with a heavy package this time. They brought Shane Gutlup and Cole Langer into the backfield. Be lead blockers for Zach Zenner.
First and goal at the 1. Zenner takes the direct snap, looking for room off the left side, untouched, into the end zone for a South Dakota State touchdown. Only 8 seconds left. Indiana State takes the snap to Parrish, and he got clocked by JT Hassel and fumbled the football. There is 2 seconds left in the half, and SDSU recovered it. Sycamores have 3 defensive backs hanging around at the goal line. 3 down linemen for Indiana State. Sumner takes the snap. He has time. He'll go deep, and he will throw it into the end zone, batted away from Schneider. Schneider had a chance at it. He went up, and Mark Seawall batted it away from the wide receiver out the back of the end zone for an incomplete pass. What a crazy finish to this first half. Halftime, it's Indiana State 9 and South Dakota State 7. Halfway through the third quarter, trailing by 2. Sumner in the shotgun from his own 9, first and 10. Fakes to Zenner. He'll throw slant over the middle. Winicky makes the catch across the 20, breaks a tackle, 30. Angling right side to midfield. Cuts back left side, 40. He's inside the 30. Jukes back right side, 20. He's inside the 10, to the 5, to the end zone for a 91-yard South Dakota State touchdown. And for the first time today, SDSU has the lead. This is the 6th 3-and-out for Indiana State. Ume is 9th punt. He just does get it away. A spiraling kick to the near side. Butler at the 40. Up the middle, 45. Jukes a man midfield. Veers back left side, 45. He's ankle tackled inside the 40 as he dives to the Indiana State 37. That's a 23-yard return. Sumner will be in the pistol. Zenner behind him and to his left. Jacks at the Indiana State 37. Quick swing pass to Trevor Wesley. He'll use Larvis Jones as a blocker and get about 4 yards. And now here comes Justin Sirovodka. This will be a 46-yard attempt off the hold of Tyler Finnis. Good snap, good hold. Sirovodka end over end. It is good. It just cleared. Parrish in the shotgun. Sycamores at their own 7, first and 10. A back to either side of the senior QB who hands to Buck Logan. Tries to run right side, breaks one tackle, breaks a second. Physical run by Logan. Cole Langer from behind tackles him near the 15-yard line. 3rd and 2 at the 15. Parrish will throw the hook to the right side, and it is caught for a first down. Forsyth tackles Gary Owens after a 4-yard gain to his own 19. The Sycamores need 10 from their own 19. Parrish to throw. Has time. He'll go deep down the middle of the field. What a jumping catch. One-handed by Robert Tanyan as he's tackled by Nick Mears at the SDSU 45. 36 yards. On 3rd and 2 against 4 down linemen, it's Logan up the middle, breaks a big run inside the 30. Jukes left side, 20. Angling left sideline inside the 10, and he is shoved out of bounds, and an official went down, as at the 2-yard line, they'll mark him out of bounds. 2 lead blockers line up almost as wingbacks, both to the right for Logan. He'll take the handoff. He'll dive into the pile inside the 1. That football came free. Bobbitt came away with it, and they've yet to signal anything. Logan dove over the pile and stretched the football out, trying to get into the end zone. Bobbitt took it away. So 1st and 10, SDSU at its own 2. I formation. Sumner under center, hands to Zenner, who fights his way out across his own 5 near his own 6. 1 receiver, it's Schneider wide left. I formation, Sumner back under center. Here is Zenner up the middle, out across the 10. Breaks free, 15. Down the left seam, 30. 40, he's to midfield. He's inside the 40. The foot race is on. Can Zenner outrun them? Yes, he can. 94 yards. Touchdown, South Dakota State.
He gone.
3rd down and a long 5, Indiana State near its own 15. Parrish dropping to throw. He'll throw right side and a nice catch by Gary Owen. He's knocked out of bounds at the 27-yard line. 8:25 remaining in the game. Indiana State trailing by 16, so technically they're within two scores still. Paris dropping to throw. He'll go deep down the middle of the field, overthrew everybody, picked off, running in stride, Melvin Tavares. Turns back around into Indiana State territory. Inside the 40, cuts back 35, veering left side 30, and he simply slides down there after his third interception of the season. Second and six, Jacks at the 48 of Indiana State. Fake to Mengarelli, slant to Jake Winicky, who hauls in the Sumner toss and is tackled immediately at the 38-yard line of Indiana State. Third and four at the Sycamore 31, one wide to either side. Fake to Mengarelli. Sumner wants to throw, airs it up deep to a wide open Jake Winicky, who hauls it in as he crosses the goal line. 31 yards, South Dakota State touchdown. A big road win for South Dakota State here in Terre Haute. Your final score, SDSU 32, Indiana State 17.